Yo, what's up, everybody? And welcome to another segment of The Matrix with your boy Prime. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to show y'all a little bit of, you know, frames of gameplay when it comes down to NBA Live 19 so you can see for yourself. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to show these frame by frame so y'all can break these down for yourself. And not only that, you can break these down for yourself, you can actually see some of the movement. As you see the move by Chris Paul, you know, between the legs, and as you know, you see this move, and just gonna backtrack and back it up, whoop, and you just slide it straight through, and you get to see that, and then the actual teardrop right over Morris, the defender, and you see the fluidity on it. So let's go ahead and let's turn the frame around, and then y'all can actually take a look on how Chris Paul is looking. You know, you could take a look on exactly on how he looks. You could take a look on see how, you know, how the details are. Now, a lot of people have been complaining about the actual likeness of, you know, how NBA Live 19 is looking. Now, people, you have to still understand this is an alpha build, and this is what you play at EA Play. Now, people don't understand what EA Play is. EA Play is the platform to showcase the game so people can play it. They can see it before the game is released. Now, they also been working on elements of lighting. So with elements of lighting, things are going to be a look, it's going to look a tad different than prior titles, which they do. Now, there are improvements that they could do and what they are going to do, but a lot of people fail to realize that exactly what they have to do. So as y'all looking at more moves with Chris Paul, and as you see, and I want y'all to break these down, and I want y'all to dissect these and really look. I want y'all to look at certain elements of movement. I want you to really look as much as you can. As you saw the crossover, as he went back, that's a Chris Paul move, and then he tears it up. Now take a look. I want y'all to look at it from a different angle. He backs it up, puts it through his legs. Now, some people feel that the actual ball through the legs will be a little bit OP, but the thing about this is, people, what you fail to realize is that you can stop it. If you anticipate very, very well on defense, you can stop that move. So if a person tries to cheese it, if that particular player has it in their arsenal and they can do it, then you can fully stop that move. And as you take a look, and you're looking at the movement, have a still frame so you can see. As you see, it goes right through the legs. Because we want to let y'all see it so you'll actually see that it ain't a morph. It went right through his leg. Back it up, right through the leg. So you can actually see, because a lot of people have to really pay attention to the detail and what it looks like. Now, with real player motion, you're going to see emphasis of movement. You're going to see it, okay? And as many times that we're going, you know, many times that this frame is going to be shown, you're going to see exactly how beautiful the movement really is. Now, for the ones that are in denial, which is fine, when the demo comes out, the demo comes out on the 25th of this month. So when the demo comes out, no, I'm sorry, not the 25th of this month. I'm sorry, that's for pre-orders. When the demo comes out in August, then you'll be able to play the game and get the feel for yourself. But in that meantime, there's going to be a lot of stuff that's going to be cleaned up in the game by that time. So by that time, there's going to be so much stuff that's going to be cleaned up, then you really don't have to really worry about it, about a lot of these issues. And if there are still issues that are still in the game, gladly provide your feedback. You can give it to myself, give it to other game changers that's out there, and we can gladly pass it along. Get yourself into the forums. You know, Nature Boy, he's one of the main guys in the EA forums. You know, gladly get in there, you know, and everybody will pay attention to that, you know. Or you can actually get in contact with the devs, you know, on Twitter or Facebook, whatever, which platform that you choose, and you go ahead and you give your feedback, but make sure that it's constructive. You don't want to give bad criticism. So as you're looking at this move as well, so you're looking at frame by frame. And this is the significance of doing frame by frame, because you get to see exactly how the game plays. And this is James Harden going to the rim. Hold on. So we want to back it up just a tad And you want to see him as he's coming down the court. He backs it up, and you're going to see it again. Now, these are, like I said, these are things that you're going to see. And now he attacks the basket. Okay, this is a James Harden move. This is actually what he does in real life. So the real player motion does come into play in a lot of ways, but we want you to see it in the way that it is broken down. We want you to look at it in the way that it is. He finishes up on the right hand side and he finishes with his right. So let's go ahead and just scroll a little bit through these, you know, because I really want everybody to have a full outlook on how, you know, the movement and certain things are, because a lot of people really, really think that a lot of this stuff is still the same, and it's not. And I really want y'all to pay attention to the detail on, you know, what it is that is presented in the work that the devs have done. Now, a lot of you are going to say, well, I'm a game changer and I'm being, you know, I'm just saying this to be saying it. No, if the game has problems, I am going to say that it has an issue, it has a problem, and it's going to be said extremely well. So you don't have to really worry about that. So it's not even, you know, that, you know, it's not even in that, it's that is not even the case. So people, you're going to have to stop. Now, when you're looking at this, you're going to look at the move. Look at the way the movement is. Look at every single motion. Look. And again, Chris Paul, he's going to go up. He's going to finish at the rim. Now, as you see, he didn't finish with his right. He finished with his left because he stayed away from the defense. He used his offhand. Now, Chris Paul does have that in his arsenal where he can finish with both hands. So, every single player is a little bit different. And I want to give you every single element as much as I can and break it down, because a lot of people is not really, you know, really understanding on where, you know, a lot of people what they're seeing, you know. So we have to, so this has to be broken down in certain ways so people can really see the gameplay from every aspect and every single, you know, every single element, every, you know, every angle, every element as much as possible. So we don't want you to miss out on what is presented. And as you see, you're looking at the court. Now, we're going to start this up at the top, and I'm going to let you see it from this particular view. All right? So as you're looking at this view from the top, and while you're looking at it, okay, it's the same play, but you're looking at it from a different view. You're looking at it from a different perspective. All right? Now, let's go ahead and back it up. You're going to see this play. Now, it's going to be at top of the key, you know, and you're going to see him break down Barnes. So we want to let you see it from this particular angle as we break down Barnes. Now, when you break down Barnes, now Barnes is a big, okay? And what you're looking for is, look at the size up. Look at the way the ball is going through his legs. Look at the way that he's, the ball movement. Look how crisp it looks. And the way that he handles the ball. Now, he's breaking down Barnes. He breaks it down. He finishes it with the left hand. He did not go into the defense with the right hand like some times it used to do, but you finish with the left hand, and you have the option of selecting what hand you want to finish with, but it has to be in that player's arsenal. And as long as it's in that player's arsenal, you'll be able to do certain things. And like I say, the fluidity, how everything, the movement, the way everything is, this is where the real player motion comes into play. And we really don't want people to really, we don't want people to think that the game is stiff, because the game is not stiff, okay? And they really took it out, and like Connor Dugan said, is that they have taken out a lot of the legacy issues pertaining to game animations and player sequences. So they've taken a lot of these legacy issues out of the game. So we want you to really look at the fluidity and look at everything as much as possible, so things can be, you know, so you, the player, can actually see what has been added, what's the difference in the title as much as possible. And I can't wait for a lot of people to really, really get their hands on the sticks, because once you get your hands on the sticks, you're going to really understand where we're coming from. So we're going to go back to James Harden. as you see. Now, let's get it on the right angle. As you see, he's going to size up. Look, James Harden, he goes through. He lays it up. Teardrop. Let's go ahead and take a look at it on the instant replay. Slowly. Size up. Look at that. Look at that. Right through his legs. Look how beautiful that looks. Look at that. So now, we're going to zoom this in. We're going to zoom it in so you can actually see what James actually looks like. Okay? Because a lot of people really, really are not understanding the difference in the player models. It's just the lighting. Okay? It is the lighting. And what was told and what we have gotten was that they're really trying to get the lighting elements of each arena down pat. Because each arena, the lighting of the players is completely different. So players are going to look completely different in those particular venues. You're seeing PJ Tucker right now. And you're taking a look at him. And I know a lot of you probably saw some of the screenshots that were there. But now you get to see this in a little bit more of action. And you get to see the movement and what is presented with this. So now you get to see it moving. And you get to, you know, get to spin it around. So now you get to see a little bit more than what was, you know, presented to a lot of people. Yes, screenshots are good, but now you get to see, this in motion. And it looks very good. They did an excellent job on PJ Tucker. So let's go ahead and we can look at Clint Capela. Take a look at him. Now, one thing I will say, and I didn't really, really get a chance to really dabble into this a little bit more, is that a big man in their handles, because some big men should not have handles like guards. They shouldn't. There's only a couple of bigs that should have handles like a guard. So, but as you look at Clint Capela, they did an excellent job. If you look at NBA Live 18, which I'm going to do, if you look at NBA Live 18 and you do a comparison, I know someone did a comparison with this. Clint Capela looks completely different. It is excellent. And people, you have to realize is that, you know, people are saying that the exoskeleton, you know, that the body types are not right. Trust me, they did a lot of work on these body types. They have new exoskeleton body types and what they really worked on, as you're looking at Trevor Ariza. So they have these body types and they really, really worked on these body types. Now, is certain body types that they can really work on and they can correct in time? Sure, that can all be done as the season goes on, or they can just go ahead and go back in and fix it. But for what it's worth and what they have done, when you look at the actual body types from previous titles and then from 18 to now, the difference is significant. It is like night and day, and you can really see it. If you're not really into detail and you're not looking for detail, then you're not really going to see it. But if you are the ones that are into detail and really looking at that detail, you're going to see it. As you see, you're looking at Gordon Haywood right now and the way that his movements are. And you see in his body type. Now you see how, you know, how the shoulders are and how their muscles are. So you're going to see a lot of things with these players. So I really want everybody to really, you know, take this and look at it and be like, you know what? Okay, now I'm starting to see. And once you start seeing the game on your actual monitor for yourself and you get to see it in your resolution and you get to see it in motion and you get to see it, then you'll be like, oh, okay, now I see. Okay, because sometimes pictures don't do it full justice until you actually get it on your monitor. You can zoom in close and then you can really, really see all the detail that is put into the game. Okay, same thing with the Marcus Smart, as you see. And that was Markieff Morris in the last one. But this is Marcus Smart. And you're looking at, you know, some of these screenshots and as you're looking at them. So I really want people to really, you know, just have and just take a look. And if you have not played NBA Live 18, if you have not played NBA Live 16, if you have not played 14 and 15, you will not see the significance of how dramatically player models have improved. You will not see the significance on how much work and how much better they have improved, not just on the actual player likeness and the player faces, but in the bodies. You will not see the significance in detail. Now we're looking at Kyrie Irving right now. And we can actually take a look at everything that this game is providing. And right now, I'm just giving y'all as much, you know, breakdown as I can, you know. So we're going to look at, and as you see, you're going to see so much detail in this game. Look at that. That's beautiful. And that's Kyrie Irving. As you're looking at him coming down, now he uses his right, and he used the hand to go away from the defense. If you really notice, is that in all other titles, they would use the hand that is closer to the defense instead of using the hand that's away from the D. But these are players that can use both hands and finish at the rim. Chris Paul, Kyrie Irving, James Harden. And that's just to name a few. And just clicking through all this. So I really want people to, you know, take this with a nice green thumb and just really pay attention to it and really, really focus on exactly what is being presented. You know, you don't really want to just, you know, take a look and not know what is being presented. Like, again, top of the key, going to let people see, look, cross, bam, right through the legs. And I know a lot of you are going to say this too, is that, oh, that's going to be a cheat code. No, again, you can stop it if you anticipate it. On defense, the one-on-one mechanic is absolutely phenomenal. So now, we're going to take a look at Steph Curry. So, we're going to take a look at Steph Curry and what his likeness is. So you can see for yourself. And this is in motion now. This is not steal. This is all coming from, you know, the actual replays and what, you know, what we played and what we got, you know, what's presented. And as you see it in the movement, you're going to see it. So I really want people to really, really pay attention to as much as you can. And then, you know, just take it, you know, for what it's worth. And like I said, it is great. You know, they did a great job with Stephen Curry because there's a very, very big difference from the one in 18 and then from the one that's in 19 as you're looking at it. So I really want people to really, really, you know, take a look at it. So, the next, you know, so, I mean, and again, now we're going to look at Draymond Green. And this is one of the players that a lot of people was really, really, you know, saying, well, this don't look like Draymond. People, you have to realize this. The new jerseys in the NBA now, they're a little bit more snug now. They're not as, and they have undershirts now. So, a lot of players now, they don't have it tucked. They don't have it extremely loose like they used to back in the 90s where they were really loose. A lot of these jerseys now, which Nike does make them, they make them a little bit more snug. So that's the way the jerseys look now. Now, when it comes down to the neck, that can be improved. That can be tightened up just a tad, okay? Klay Thompson, you get to look at him a little bit more closely. Now you get to see him in motion and get to see him. Now you get to see the body types. You get to see it in motion. Now, if you don't tell, if you say that does not look good to you, then I don't know what to tell you. I really don't know what to tell you. It looks good to me. And when you get the final build, it's going to look extremely amazing. Look at the movement. Okay? And another thing that y'all want to know too is that they took some of those automatic animations out of the game. So you don't get locked in into those particular type of animations, you know, when you're dribbling the ball up the court. You don't get locked in those anymore. They took them out. Again, like I stated, those legacy issues are not there. They took them out. And they did a great job with Klay, as you're seeing. All right? And you can't tell me that while y'all looking at this, it doesn't look good. You look at the way the ball is just in the hand. Look at the way the hand is moving with the palm and the way it's moving. There's no snapping. There's no warping. There's no nothing. So when you're looking at this, you... I want people to really, really take a look. And it's very, very good. And again, I'm sorry that the video is a little bit long, but I want to give this to y'all so y'all can see for yourself. Also, here's Kevin Durant. You're going to see him move. You're going to see the way that he moves. Look at the eye dynamic. Look at the way the eye is moving. Okay? And then a lot of y'all was trolling on the goddamn LeBron James. That is an expression. He's in a defensive stance. So a lot of people need to get off of, I mean, it's kind of amazing on what people, what they get at. Okay, and you're going to look at Nick Young. So I appreciate y'all coming through this segment of The Matrix with your boy Prime. Drop your comments down. Make sure you hit me up on Twitter and Facebook and Instagram. And I hope y'all enjoyed the video. I will have more content coming soon, momentarily. And make sure y'all subscribe to the channel as well. All right, y'all. I'm out. Peace.